Now, in the meanest part of the year, when the daylight was as short as the stub of a candle, it was the custom on the longest night of winter to hold a celebration. And this happy time was called the winter solstice. Simple gifts were exchanged. Nestor's mother gave him a bright pair of stockings Olaf's wife had thrown away. It was a beautiful time, full of peace and goodwill, while the others were even friendly to Nestor.
Sorry if I made you feel bad, Nestor.
This is the best day ever. I'll never forget it.
And when the celebration was over, they all fell into a deep and contented sleep. Except for Nestor, who, tired as he was just too excited to go to sleep.
Where the blazes are they?
What's happening? What's going on?
The Emperor needs donkeys. Strong, young donkeys. Show them to me.
This way, sir. I've got several fine colts.
He was a soldier from the Imperial Roman Army. Beasts of burden were needed in the Southlands.
Fine young specimens, aren't they?
They'll do. You two.
Master!
What's he doing?
Taking us away.
Away? No! Mama!
Come back here, you. What the blazes? Those ears, they're so long they drag the ground. You try to cheat the Emperor? You would sell him imperfect misfits?
You can have him for nothing. Free.
I'll teach you. I'll have them all for nothing. And you can keep little droopy ears. Forward, slaves. For the glory of the Roman Empire.
You! Look what you've done to me! No young donkeys, no silver coins. I'm a pauper! Blast you!
No! Nestor, my son.
I don't care if the storm freezes you. Get out and never come back.
Must be brave. Remember that. Whatever happens, you must be brave.
Finding a sheltered spot, Nestor's mama dug away the snow until she came to the winter grass underneath.
Lie in there, Nestor.
But Mama...
Do as you're told, Nestor.
Yes, Mama.
The grass was cold and hard, but better than the icy snow. And Nestor's mama covered his entire body with her own, except for...
ears, Nestor.
Yes, Mama.